Chapter 15. Per aspera ad astra.
I couldn't sleep. Things were bad, and they were only gonna get worse. The truth was gonna come out sooner or later. And then we were gonna have Falcone after us, along with the Chinese and Vinci. This wasn't how I imagined it when we were starting out. I dreamed of money, cars, women, respect, freedom. I guess I ended up getting all that, more or less. But along with it came prison, living in constant fear, and the blood of my friends. I ducked it as long as I could, but it was finally catching up with me. It was all just a matter of time.
Hello and welcome to the pit. I am still living in a crap hole and the weather is terrible and somebody is ringing me.
Yeah, hello.
Vito. Yeah, it's Eddie. Listen, I need you to...
Let me guess. You need me to come by right away and I should bring a gun.
For once I don't. Carla wants to see you over at the planetarium.
Did you say what it was about?
Nope. Better head over there now, though. Don't want to keep the man waiting. Yeah, see you, Vito.
Ominous. And he doesn't want me to bring a gun. Well, if I'm going to be meeting the boss, and it's raining, better bring on the casual suit and raincoat. Oh god, yeah, it's terrible weather. Let's see what my equipment's at. Ooh. Got a shotgun. Got a Tommy. Got a Thompson. Got some grenades.
Mr. Scaletta, can you get in, please?
Hey, old man. What are you doing back?
Just get in the damn car. Now.
And you are?
This is our friend, Mr. Chu.
All right, so what the hell's going on here? What is this?
This is about you. You fucked up good, didn't you? Started a fucking war.
Got no idea what you're talking about.
Don't fuck with me, boy. I've probably forgotten more about this business than you'll ever learn. Half our guys are dead. Half of Mr. Chu's guys are dead. And now the feds are breathing down everybody's necks. Because of you.
What's with your eyes?
Well, listen.
You listen. If it wasn't for me, you would have already been taken care of. So you're gonna listen to what I have to say, and you're gonna listen good. What you did in Chinatown, that was because of that cocksucker Henry, right? You know who he was working for when he died?
You mean when he was butchered?
He was working for the feds. He was a fucking rat. That's why Mr. Chu's people did what they did. And that's why the feds are going after Carlo now. But I don't forget my friends, Vito. You did for me, so I did for you. I called in a few favors. Got you one chance to make this right.
Okay, I'm listening.
You're gonna get rid of Carlo. Do us all a favor.
And if I refuse?
You die. Frank and the rest of the commission want you dead. So does Mr. Chu. And to top it all off, you vouched for a rat. You think Carlo's gonna let that slide? You're a dead man walking.
When?
Now. Every minute we wait is another minute we give to the feds. He's holed up at that observatory of his. You know something's up. Carlo Falcone is a lot of things, but stupid ain't one of them.
All right. Stop the car.
Remember, kid, this is your last chance.
I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Serious moments and all, But did anyone else catch the fact that apparently the Mafia has been possessed by the devil? I saw what was happening to that guy driving shotgun. He rotated his head 180 degrees. You do not twist your head like that and not be possessed by the devil. Right, now that that's out of my system, where am I? What's going on? Oh, you didn't drop me off. I'm miles away from my bloody car. I need a car.
Get the fuck out.
Oh God, please, no!
Get in the damn car. What the hell? Hey, go away. I want to drive my own bloody car, thank you very much. You didn't half drop me a mile away from home, did you? How much money do I have? Oh! Well, at least I have money. Which I'm probably going to need. Okay, first thing I'm going to do is I've noticed my health. I'm going to do what I forgot to do after the phone call. Yes, I will open the window. I want no sandwiches. Fine, I'll have a Swift Cola. Now, I'm going to have a... get in my car. I think this is a serious enough moment that I, and the weather's crap enough, I will take the Jefferson. Also, the fact that it hasn't been upgraded offends me, so I will go to a body shop. Besides which, I have learnt that this game likes to take away my money at a moment's notice. Better to spend it while I have it. But I'm going to meet the boss, I need to drive in a classy car. And because it's raining, I need a bloody roof. I'm not driving in a convertible in this weather. Even if I am wearing a raincoat. Yes, I have been tasked with killing the Don. This would be the second Don I have to my name. Although technically... technically Carlo is Joe's... technically Carlo is Joe's kill, so... I'll let him have that.
Looking for a new set of wheels? Take your pick, pal.
I'll take those ones, thank you. The plates are fine.
Here you go, pick a design.
I mean, holy hell, I have a lot of money. I don't know why I've got so much money, to be honest. Ah, wrong button.
Thanks a lot, pal. I appreciate the business.
You can appreciate all the business. Right, next stop. I will go to Giuseppe. Look at this car. Look at it. I mean, I might have lost everything twice, but I've still got my provincial. I've still got my cars, and I'm back to having 27k, which is convenient. Wait, why am I going that way? I'm trying to follow the damn red light. Giuseppe, where are you?
In pursuit of a hit-and-run driver. Copy that.
Oi!
What can I get you this time?
Here
you
go.
Use it in good health.
Don't need more lockpicks.
That should work for you.
Oh.
I'm sure you'll find a good use for this.
1911 special. Not bad.
I don't have to tell you to be careful.
Yeah, you don't have to tell me. Careful. I think I am well stocked. Let's go repair my car because I am affected.
Afternoon, Vito.
Yes, I am being pedantic about the state of my car, but...
Vito, just tell me what you need.
I'm meeting the boss. I am going to kill the boss.
Pick a design.
I might as well look good while doing it.
Any color. Thanks, Vito. I appreciate the business.
I mean, okay, it's a bit of a tacky. I suppose you could argue it's a bit tacky to drive with flames on my car, but I like the look. So I need to go there. First, I would like to go meet Harry. If I'm to kill a Don without the aid of a bomb wiping out a bunch of his... For God's sake. Without the aid of a bomb blowing up a bunch of his dudes, I'm going to need to be fully loaded with whatever I can get my hands on. Imagine trying to drive with simulation driving on right now. I'll be slipping and sliding everywhere. Bloody red roads. I'm turning into Scooby-Doo. Red roads. Yeah, wet roads. Wet roads, heavy rain. Oh yeah, I never noticed that the windscreen wipers actually work in this game before. That's a nice touch. Harry, I've come to buy guns.
Yeah, what's up?
It's me, Vito.
Okay, come in.
Hey, Harry.
I got all the guns you'll ever need.
Thompson, nope. Right. Ooh, grenades.
Here you go, Vito.
96s. Really, you don't have any ammo for the modern Thompson? The Thompson M1? Now that really offends me, because that's the one I want the most. Fine, whatever.
Whatever you're doing out there, it's good for business.
Still, I have the weapons I need. I have the two Thompsons. You've seen how devastating I am when I actually use Thompsons. I'm good to go. Time to meet the boss. Time to finish this and, you know, secure my life. Oh god, this is going to go terribly. This drive. It's not really much to talk about. We're coming up to a confrontation. I am coming up to a terrible drive. I cannot drive to save my life. So, Harry truly was a mole for the feds. I still don't think he deserved quite what he got, but whatever. I'm on the shit list of everybody in the bloody city, to the point that even Leo was disappointed in me, but he returned the favour. So all is good. I will clear my name.
Hey, fellas.
Hey, Vito. The boss wants to see you.
Good. I want to see him, too.
One thing, though, Vito. I gotta take your gun.
Yeah, all right. Here you go.
Ooh, cold. And efficient. Oh! They were very quick to actually get their shots on me. Ow! That was painful. But I will sort this. Cover. Oh! What a throw! Shotgun. Aha! Thompsons. They were using good old Thompson M1A1s. Oh! Come on, you're alive. Ha ha ha. I mean, I could have used the shotgun there. Here it's... You steal that? You had this coming, asshole. Grenades are my friends. That's rude. You know, I refuse to touch that. What was that from? I kind of cried bullshit that he survived that first one. I hit him in the head. Making good use of my grenades in this mission. There we go. I have to go down, but I will go up first, because why not? Yes, I feel the need to dick around with the telescope, apparently. Ah! Oh, that'll learn me. Apparently they don't like me dicking around with the telescope. Thank you. I saw you. Oh, is it an immortal? Invincible glass. You want to stick it back up?
Come on, shoot the fuck.
No, don't shoot the fuck. Ha! Ah, there was another one. Oh, you can't take me. I was trained to kill by the army. Was that all of them? I think that was all of them.
Go, go, I'm covering you!
I don't think that was all of them. Leave me alone. Gonna make an appearance. You're going to die. Maybe I should have grabbed an M1. It would have been a... would have had the accuracy factor. Only 2 bullets, so. Nope. Don't do that. I'm not going to run out of bullets anytime soon. Even if I run out of bullets for this one, I've got the other one. Right. There we go. Are you going to stick your head back up? Yeah, that looks safe. Someone else? cover. You just can't trust anyone these days. Explore distant space.
Well, look who it is. This is who they send? This is an insult. What'd they tell you, Vito? Take care of me and all's forgiven? You really think they're just gonna let you walk after everything you did? Then again, chumps like you never do think about the big picture. But your buddy Joe understands, don't you, Joe?
What the fuck is this?
I could ask you the same question.
Loyalty's a funny thing, huh, Vito? No such thing as friendship in this business. Didn't your old pal Leo teach you that while you're sucking his cock back in the can? You're just a fucking pawn, Vito. It's all you ever were. When are you gonna realize
Joe,
that?
Joe, you just gotta trust me.
You think I give a shit about the feds? All those tired old fucks on the commission? They're using you, Vito. Just like Clemente used you. Just like I used you. Just like that rat fuck Henry used you. You vouch for that piece of shit. Brought him into my house. And now, you dumb fuck, you're gonna pay for it. Now, Joe.
Hey, if you're gonna pull that trigger, do it already.
What are you waiting for?
Vito, let's shoot this cocksucker.
Remember what we talked about,
three.
Joe? You're gonna throw
one,
all that away? Do it!
Two.
Now!
My friendship with Joe knows no bounds. We are thick as thieves. Is that the saying?
God damn it! Somebody kill these two psychos!
You dumb bastard! You don't stand a chance. You can't kill them all.
Try it. Try us. I was trained to kill by the army, and Joe's. Joe. Oh, never mind. I was trained to die by the army, apparently. Yeah, me and Joe, we're two peas in a pod. You cannot separate us. I will just happily die for him. Repeatedly. Not exactly a great spot cover. It helps when... God, they're suddenly very accurate. I did better on that first try when I didn't know where they were. Got you. Right. Let's look for a better spot.
God damn it! Somebody kill these two psychos!
There we go. I think I found the optimum cover spot.
You dumb bastard, you don't stand a chance! You can't kill them all!
Nope.
You really are insane, aren't you?
I enjoy watching you die.
Hey, look! Right, over already. There! There's only two of them!
Yeah, there's only two, but that's more than enough to take you on. Circling around, so let's... Oh, no, don't do that.
You know something, Carlo? For the last 10 years, all I've done was kill. I killed for my country. I killed for my family. I killed anybody that got in my way. But this one... This one's for me.
Fuck you!
Fucking prick.
I sure as hell hope you know what you're doing here.
Don't worry, I took care of it. You'll see. So, what was he talking about back there?
Nothing. He made me an offer, that's all.
Yeah, I figured out that much. What kind of offer?
He wanted me to whack it. Said he'd make me a capo. Give me my own crew. You know, pretty much everything I ever wanted.
Yeah? So why the hell didn't you do it?
Remember that $5 you owe me?
Oh, no. Of course I'm going for the side that doesn't actually open.
What the hell is this?
It's all right, Joe.
Is it done?
It's done.
All right, then. Looks like a celebration is in order. Come on, let's head to the cat house.
Sounds good to me.
Come with me, Vito. There's more we need to talk about.
All right, we'll see you over there.
All right. So what's the big secret? Hey, what the hell's going on? Where they taking Joe?
Sorry, kid. Joe wasn't part of our deal.
And thus ends Mafia 2. Bit of classical jazz. Unlike the last game, I like this credit music. Yeah. As I said, when I began playing... when I began recording this playthrough, Mafia 2 came out in a time when I wanted a bit more simplicity in games. Just wanted to be able to relax the brain and not have to worry too much about convoluted control schemes or complicated gameplay mechanics. It was a game where I could just pop in the disc and throw myself into the action with no issues whatsoever. Does it still hold up? I think it still holds up as a good solid action game. I mean, simulation mode, yeah, I'm so thankful I turned that off because I definitely enjoyed the game more once I wasn't slipping and sliding like a complete and utter blithering fool. But, yeah, compared to Mafia 1, it was simplistic, but it was what I needed for the time. And I still think it holds up. Maybe it's me just having nostalgia. Maybe it's my rose-tinted goggles. Let me not think about it too much on the downsides. Though I will say, this definitive edition, some of the graphical hiccups, that weird, I'm going to repeat myself, let's go to this, that was weird, and Leo's eyes during that cutscene in the car, where it was constantly, I know, it's like he was rolling his eyes constantly at me, it's like, wow Leo, you suddenly turned really sarcastic. One issue, minor quibble I do have, is they re-released Mafia 1 in a definitive edition. Shortly before that came out, this remaster of Mafia 2 came out. I just played the Mafia 2 definitive edition. Yes, I'm making funny sounds. Because I feel like they should have done a more of a direct port to the Mafia 3 engine as they had with Mafia 1 to the Definitive Edition. Even if it's just a port, just some of the gameplay mechanics downgrading if you're playing through the series now. So we go from Mafia 1 Definitive Edition, which has melee attached to a particular key on the keyboard. Yeah, car shoot, well, drive-by shooting. You get grenades keyed to a specific button. You go to this one where I need to manually equip my fists or my grenades. And that took away any sort of... Well, it took away most of the times I would have used a grenade under normal circumstances because I had to manually equip the bloody thing. Well, that's not even getting into my terrible luck with throwing the bloody things in this one. From a story perspective, yeah, I enjoyed... Again, I enjoyed this story for this one. I preferred the story for Mafia 1, but again, Mafia 2's story, it was solid and it was different from Mafia 1. It didn't try to do the same thing. Mafia 1 was the romanticisation of the mob life. Mafia 2 was almost a cautionary tale. It went into how fickle the life of crime was. Vito had his high moments, but they were very shortly taken up by the lows. He started getting somewhere, and then he got thrown in the slammer. He got his dream home, and then it got burnt down. He lost everything to the life of crime for the short moments of high. And I'm not saying that... I mean, you do hear about criminals who have managed to maintain sort of a rich lifestyle. There's that former mobster, I can never remember his name. You occasionally catch him on YouTube videos reacting to Mafia-based stories and video games and movies, and giving his perspective as a real-life mobster. And it's like, from what I've heard, he had a lot of the highs. I don't really hear about his lows. So, I'm not saying it's not out of the realm of possibility in fiction for these criminals to have their high lives, to be the Tommy Vercettis, the Scarfaces, I've forgotten his name. But it's far more likely that you're going to go through what Vito went through. You get the high payout, you get the short moments of high, and then it all goes to shit. And that was the recurring thing for him. He got his highs, and then it went to shit. He got his highs, it went to shit. Because he never wanted to do... Well, he wanted to do right by his family, but he only knew how to do it in the most damaging way possible, the short-sighted way. His sister's husband is cheating on her and partying, and he goes and resorts straight to the fists to the face. He might have got away with that, but then he outright threatens his life over the phone to his sister, and his sister's reaction is pretty understandable, disgusted, stay away from us, hang up. And to my knowledge, Vito never hears from his sister again. I mean, I liked the fact that Joe didn't actually betray him at the end. They were friends through and through. They did stick together. It doesn't seem to have worked out for Joe, because Vito, again, he short-sighted all that. He never thought to ask about Joe when the arrangement was being made with Leo. He just assumed, well, it's all sorted, it's all dusted. Surely Joe's part of the package. And as we saw, they just drove off, and presumably Joe's going to get whacked in the middle of a graveyard or something. And I'm loath to consider what Joe's final thoughts would be if that was the case. Because the last words Vito gave to Joe were a reassurance. Don't worry, it's all sorted, it's all done, trust me. And then he's driven off to be whacked. Ew. I mean, would Joe understand that Vito didn't realise that that Joe wasn't part of the thing, or would Joe feel betrayed? It's like, oh, I just betrayed my Don, betrayed this deal that could have made me a capo for my friend, who then betrayed me in order to keep his own life. But that's life in the criminal underbelly of society. Even when something supposedly as sophisticated and civilized as the mob, it's a dog-eat-dog world. And Mafia 2 was far more into that particular aspect of criminal life than Mafia 1 was. So it's a bit, I can't even say bittersweet ending, because it's just such a downer ending. Yes, Vito is alive, but he's basically wiped out two mob families. He's got no real freedom from the mob now. He's indebted. How are things going to go for Vito? I mean, on the upside, he didn't break the immerta. He's not going to get... It's not a guaranteed thing he's going to get whacked, unlike Tommy. But, yeah. Graphically, I've seen better remasters. I mean, come on, if I... Skyrim, for example, fans have made better remasters from that in mods. I can just download 10k texture packs or whatever, and they look better. So, I don't know, as a remaster goes, it... Don't make me wrong, when I looked at a comparison picture between the original version and the definitive edition, there are differences. It does look better. But it doesn't feel like they reached for the full potential they could have. Honestly, I would have preferred for a Mafia 2 Definitive Edition, they'd given it the same treatment that Mafia 1 Definitive got, and just straight up remade the gameplay in the engine, ported it to the Mafia 3 engine. But it is what it is. It just means when playing through the games in order now, you got sort of a downgrade of gameplay in between Mafias 1 and 3 now, which, okay, whatever. Joe's Adventure, oh, the AI on that was ridiculously aggressive. I didn't enjoy the timed nature of all the missions. I didn't like how most of them had no real context. It's just, you go here, suddenly you're told, get to this hearse that has cut brakes and get it to the garage down at Charlie's place. Okay, great, thanks. The story missions were good, but even then there was a shocking lack of context with them. It's like, we go to rob the supermarket, go to the mission start, and suddenly we're just in there already being shot at. I would have preferred a cutscene of Joe and his friend going in and shouting, "This is a robbery!" And then the security getting... At least then there would have been context, instead of an instant, "Oh, we're in the middle of it." But, again, this is me, and I'm probably never going to go back to Joe's Adventures, or if I do, I'll use the save file of this completed game and just go straight to all of the story missions and ignore everything else. The spawning enemies, how aggressive they were. It's like, I played the main campaign on hard mode, I played Joe's Adventures on hard mode. Really, they should be the same level of difficulty, but considering how easily I just strolled through the main story of Mafia 2 compared to Joe's Adventure, there were a couple of instances where the scenario got the better of me in the main game, but nowhere near to the level that they did in Joe's Adventure. Joe's Adventure royally kicked me in the arse, probably with a steel toe-capped boot, just to really add to the ouch factor. Do I recommend Mafia 2 after all this time? Yes, I do still recommend it. It liked Vito as a character, his killing of Tommy Angelo notwithstanding. I liked the camaraderie between him and Joe. I liked how it was more of a... It was a more grim... Not grim, not... It was less about the high life and more about the realities of life of crime. I like that. It's short though. I will give it that. It felt really short considering... I think I... hold on, so let me think about this. In the recording of the main game, all round it took me 3 days of playing, and I could have done that in one if I wasn't recording and therefore had to stop every so often, because if I recorded the entire game in one sitting and there was a crash in the recording software, I would have blown a fuse. But yeah, I mean, I suppose compared to some games, it's an average length, but I strolled through that so quickly, it felt so short compared to other games that, well, take it or leave it. So yes, I recommend Mafia 2 Definitive Edition. Mafia 2 Definitive Edition is available on Steam for £25 or the US equivalent, I would imagine for the US equivalent. Yes, unlike with Mafia 1, I am double checking. Mafia 2 Classic is not strictly speaking for sale. If you get Mafia 2 Definitive Edition, you get Mafia 2 Classic free of charge. So I would say that's two games for the price of one, but they're the same game. One just happens to be a HD remastering. It's interesting. Reviews tend to say play Classic rather than the broken remaster. After some of the hiccups I had with this recording, with this playthrough, I'm inclined to agree. Stick with Mafia 2 Classic if you have the choice. I'm honestly wish I'd played through Mafia 2 Classic rather than the Definitive Edition, but this is a playthrough of all the Definitive Editions, so it is what it is. And hey, I've experienced it for myself. At the end of the day, who can you trust but yourself and your own experiences? I could trust people on the internet, or I can trust my own account. So don't take my word as gospel. If you feel the need to check for yourself, check for yourself. If not, hey, who better to trust than a random idiot on the internet whose Let's Play you just watched? Well, that'll be it for this episode. Next time we meet, I will be playing Mafia 3 Definitive Edition, a game I have never played. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.